ex-Slipknot singer re-records their debut album? Sign me up. Hi people, and now my Chili Con Carne's crew is Chili here, the man who produces Iron From My Eyes, and this is a 5-minute review on Chaosus and Anders Colsefni. Mate, feed, kill, repeat. Slipknot are easily one of the biggest bands to emerge from the last 25 years, and have been a force of nature for the metal scene, introducing many a new metalhead to it. It seems eons ago that I, like many, first heard that self-titled debut album by Slipknot and thought, this was the heaviest metal I've ever heard. Oh, how naive I was back then. This was also the case for believing that this was Slipknot's debut album, when only a few years prior, they had released a demo called Mate, Feed, Kill, Repeat with their original singer Anders Colsefni. But the original EP is an elusive collector's item passed on eBay for money rather than the music these days, similar to the Linkin Park EP. So it seems like a perfect pairing to revisit what was the original sound as an idea for how it evolved and changed in the last couple of years, and to see if I enjoy it on the other end of the spectrum, especially considering that Anders released this in memory of Joey and Paul Gray. Rock in peace, you guys. First and foremost, the band Chaosus is a New Zealand-based metal band that have worked with a few new metal names in the past, so it's a perfect pairing for Anders to join them for this record. And the next question I think most Slipknot fans will ask is, how does it stack compared to the originals? It is very different to say the least, and a different kind of beast that I feel metal purists who hate Slipknot would take this album and sing its praises for its brutality, especially in Anders' vocals, which are more death metal growls as opposed to the melodic vocals of Corey as they would become. Of the 8 tracks, 4 of these songs would make it on their way to their breakthrough debut album, and I figured that they would be easy to pick up. But to be honest, these variants are unrecognizable to their original pieces. Maybe that's because I am slightly musically illiterate. Maybe it's because the vocals have thrown me off, or maybe it's because after all these years of listening to the same version, I cannot distinguish anything else. But without a doubt, these tunes sound nothing like what they are used to. They sound sinister, dark, twisted, as if by some dark mark of Cain, or like viewing an alien being, you know something is off. But the interest is still high. I wasn't turned off by what I was hearing, but instead enjoying this effort. It feels like a fresh new record when going through a playthrough, to be honest, and the songs I was more unfamiliar with were piquing my curiosity, such as Do Nothing, Bitch Slap, and Confessions, which came across as this weird mix of funk metal and rap that clearly has some Mr. Bungle influences, especially the latter with the small horn sections. I can see why these songs were left off any subsequent releases. I couldn't say that I found some feel particularly interesting, and couldn't recall it in writing this part, to be honest though. The album stays true to its original track listing, with the exception being the last track, Killers and Queens, which has the hidden track and 20 minute runtime down to a 7 minute track. And this feels like the band were trying to tap into their inner Tool fan and recreate the song Flood from The Undertow on here. Not a bad song to try and emulate, to be fair. If last year gave rise to the notion of Redux, then this is the example I would say it can work. But then another thought nagged my head. What could have been? If Slipknot had chosen to keep Anders as their singer, how much would have changed? Because while I think Anders is a solid singer for his style, I just don't feel like he would have been the right fit for Slipknot. And while this album has been fun to hear, I'm glad they chose Corey Taylor for future releases, because his ability to blend melody with power was a perfect fit for the band. I guess Anders and Chaosus have created an interesting insight into a previous sound here, but I know a fair few Slipknot fans won't particularly care for these efforts, because, and to be fair, these songs were already perfected years ago. Still, this has to be the best thing I've heard at a Slipknot band camp in the past few years. Overall, I would give this album a score of 7 million chilies on the spicy scale, with my favourite tracks being Slipknot, Do Nothing, Bitch Slap, and Only One. At the end of the day, this album serves twofold. As a comparison for the band that was to now, and also for the fact that this music is now more readily accessible for all the fans to enjoy. And it's good that they have, because now it's more easily accessible being on a streaming platform, and I think hardcore fans will truly enjoy what has been offered by Anders, and clearly been done with passion in mind. If you are a Slipknot fan, it is well worth a listen, and I could highly recommend this album. Go check it out now. If you've enjoyed this content, make sure to smash that like button, subscribe to us, and stay notified for future music-related content, because it keeps our manager happy at the end of the day. We are also on Discord, Instagram, Facebook, and all those other social platforms if you want to check us out. As always, people, you have a great day, and stay spicy.